The other thing I started working on at that time was a completely off-the-wall project that became another book later on called 316. So 316 is a book it's different from any other book that's ever been written, and there are either two reasons why this happened. One is that it was a stupid idea to write such a book. What's the other reason that could be different? Anyway, that there was, that just, it was, the time was finally ripe to write such a book, I suppose. Anyway, the 316 is a study of the Bible from a different perspective than has been used before, so I have to explain it a little bit. The computer scientists find it very natural to, when they're studying a complicated thing, to look at random parts of that thing and then probe those in depth and try to learn something about the whole by having a few parts that they understand well. It's like the Gallup poll, where the Gallup poll will come and interview several people, and after interviewing 1,000 people, they'll speak for for what they think millions of people are like, and the Nielsen ratings and so on are based on sampling. Well, I would use sampling when I was grading papers. If somebody gives me a term paper, I don't have time to read all 50 pages of the term paper. I'll choose a random page or so, and then I'll see what that leads me to. Student doesn't know in advance which page I'm going to do. So anyway, sampling is something that comes naturally to a computer scientist. One day in the 70s, I said, well, what would happen if I tried this on the Bible? That's a complicated thing. What if I looked at random parts of the Bible and just to see what people, and go to the library and see what people have said about those parts? Instead of somebody telling me what part of the Bible to look at, I would just take an ordinary part, one that wasn't pre-planned, and I would see whether or not I could learn something that way. And I found it was really interesting to do this. In fact, I did it with a group of people at our local church, and we decided that we would go through and we would study chapter 3, verse 16 of every book of the Bible. So we started with Genesis 3:16 and then Exodus 3:16, and we continued through till we got to Revelation 3:16. And I told you that I had gone to Lutheran schools as a child, so I had been exposed to the Bible, but I never felt that there was any part of it that I knew well. This way, I would have some 60 verses of the Bible that I would really have nailed. I could say I knew Genesis 3:16 rather thoroughly, because I could go to Stanford Library and I could check out all the commentaries on Book of Genesis, and there was only a few pages to read that would tell me what's important about Genesis 3:16. So this sampling idea was a big win, not for understanding the Bible so much, but for understanding the secondary literature, for understanding the commentaries about the Bible. You could pretty well see how the opinions changed during the centuries about these different verses, you could see that a lot of people had different insights, and other people hadn't done their homework very well, and so on. But you could get a pretty good idea on these thousands and thousands and thousands of books written about the Bible as to what their slant was, if you just happened to know a few parts to probe into. Anyway, this was a surprisingly effective way to learn something about the Bible, and so it's one of these moments again where I wake up in the middle of the night and I say, hey, this would be a good book to where I could take the things that I had learned in the library about the 316 verses and explain them to other people. That, you know, it was a story that I think other people would enjoy learning about as well.